Hi, my name is Jeff Abers. I am the chair of the Department of Earth and Atmospheric Sciences here at Cornell. I'm also an earthquake seismologist. Today, we're not at the CUBO borehole site. We're at a different field site where we have this one of several earthquake monitoring pieces of equipment in the ground. There's been a lot of questions that have been asked about seismicity and earthquakes related to CUBO. And so this is part of our strategy for addressing that, try to understand that. What we're really trying to do with these instruments is get a good sense of the background rate of earthquake activity, of seismicity, in the Ithaca area. There's no evidence of very large earthquakes or even felt earthquakes very close to Ithaca that we know about, but like everywhere on the planet, there's very, very tiny earthquakes occurring all the time. In the last 2 years, we've recorded and located about 100 very small earthquakes. By very small, we use the Richter scale magnitudes. These are magnitudes less than one. The magnitude scale is open at both ends. Each one is about 30 in energy, so a magnitude zero has about 30 times less energy than magnitude one. We're seeing a lot of magnitude minus one, so they're 30 times smaller than that. Most of them tend to be near the lake, near downtown Ithaca, and we actually think a lot of these are not real earthquakes. A lot of them seem to be located, say, near the train lines. They're so tiny, the energy related to them is about the equivalent of a train starting and stopping. There's also some maybe related to construction activity, or there may be some natural things as well that are happening. What we're looking at is instrumentation in the box that's recording a sensor that's buried over there underground. The sensor records very, very tiny ground motions. That information comes in here and then is sent through a cell phone modem. There's a little antenna on the solar panel back there. There are 15 of these around the greater Ithaca area, and these form the network that's monitoring very, very tiny earthquakes or earthquake-like signals around the CUBO site. We don't actually expect to record anything directly related to CUBO. Remember, CUBO is the borehole observatory part of the Earth Source Heat Project. It's being drilled to sample the formations, to monitor, to understand much better the conditions so we can evaluate how and whether to do the big geothermal project. But the idea is that this gives us a much better idea of the background. In case anything does happen, we'll know about it. So all of this data that we're collecting here is being telemetered to a central facility where we're detecting and locating earthquakes in as close to real time as possible. So stay tuned, look at that site, gather more information about the project.